Hello everyone, welcome to the new session in this lecture series on genetics and molecular biology. I'm Dr. Yogesh Pawade. We have been covering topics in competency BSA 1.2. We have covered DNA replication and now we are going on to cover DNA repair. So coming to the DNA repair system, we will take an overview of DNA repair systems and various defects first of all, and then we'll discuss individual DNA repair systems in detail in subsequent classes. So the specific learning objectives of this session are enumerating different types of DNA damage and enumerate different types of DNA repair systems. So at the end of the session, the students shall be able to enumerate different types of DNA damage and they should be able to enumerate different types of DNA repair systems. So what are the possible DNA damage? What are the possible causes of DNA damage? So it may be a single base alteration where you'll find deprivation, deamination of cytosine to uracil, then deamination of adenine to hypoxanthine, alkylation of base and base analog incorporation. Then there are two base alterations also, where there are UV light induced thymine-thymine dimers, maybe cytosine-cytosine dimers are also formed. So basically these are pyrimidine dimers which are formed due to UV light. Then bifunctional alkylating agent, cross linkages are also seen and that is a possible cause of DNA damage. So next possible cause is chain breaks, where you'll find the causes like ionizing radiation, radioactive disintegration of backbone element, and then oxidative free radical formation also leads to chain breaks and the DNA damage. Next is cross linkage. These cross linkages are seen between bases in same or opposite strands, or those cross linkages are seen in DNA and the DNA protein molecules like histones. So because of the cross linkages, the replication and other processes like transcription, these processes are affected and those processes cannot continue. The DNA damage can be caused due to chemicals that interact with DNA. Okay, these are the possible causes of DNA damage. What are they? They are single base alteration, two base alteration, then there are chain breaks, then there are cross linkages, and there are certain chemicals which interact with DNA, which leads to DNA damage. Now let us see what are the possible mechanisms of DNA repair which can correct the DNA damage. So they are nucleotide excision repair. There is base excision repair also. There are homologous and non-homologous end joining repairs are there which can correct the DNA damages. Then photoreactivation is also there. Then there is recombinational repair. There is DNA mismatch repair, which correct the single base damage. Then there is strand directed mismatch repair. Then one more, there is transcription coupled repair is also there. Then there is methyl group removal from the methylated base. And there is one more, that is OxoG, that is oxoguanine to adenine repair. So we'll see an overview of application of these mechanisms of DNA repair to a particular type of DNA damage. So let us see what are the mechanisms of DNA repair and what are the possible DNA damages it can repair. So these are DNA repair pathways, these are DNA damaging agents, and these are the DNA lesions which are formed due to DNA damaging agents. Okay, so we'll see what kind of fidelity of repair these repair pathways show pertaining to these DNA lesions or DNA damages occurred. So first of all, we have seen the causes of DNA damage like ionizing radiation, X-rays or anti-tumor drugs. These agents are found to cause double strand breaks. These are strands, right? So double strand breaks or single strand breaks. These factors also lead to intra-strand and inter-strand cross linkages. and these are the damages which can be corrected by non-homologous end joining and homologous recombinational repair. So to correct this, the homologous recombination repair will show you high fidelity in the repair process. Okay, so both of these work, but homologous recombination is the high fidelity repair system there. Then coming to UV light and chemicals which leads to DNA damage. So what kind of DNA damage is UV light and other chemicals are going to cause? They can form bulky adducts. These are bulky nucleotides which have a bulky size, a big size due to added groups into it. There are pyrimidine dimers, thymine, cytosine dimers which are formed here. The two thymine have formed pyrimidine dimers here. So to correct bulky adducts and pyrimidine dimers, we have a nucleotide excision repair. It has very high fidelity to repair pyrimidine dimers and bulky adducts. There might be an MCQ, right? So what kind of DNA repair pathway is used by our genetic systems to correct pyrimidine dimers? So it is nucleotide excision repair. It may also be asked, which of the two, which of the four, okay, these two options will be there along with other mechanisms also. Which of the four is the best DNA repair pathway for damages caused due to ionizing radiations and X-rays? So it is homologous recombination repair, right? So let us see what are the other damages and the possible pathways. The oxygen radicals means oxidative damage, hydrolysis and action of alkylating agents leads to abasic sites. So there is no base there, abasic sites and single strand breaks. And 8-oxygonin lesions are also formed. So which DNA damaging agents can form single as well as double strand breaks are oxygen radicals, hydrolysis by the agents and alkylating agent actions on the DNA strands. And which were the agents which leads to double stranded breaks as well as single stranded breaks? These are ionizing radiations, X-rays and anti-tumor drugs. So these agents can lead to breaks in DNA strands. Along with breaks in DNA strands, that is single strand breaks, these oxygen radicals, hydrolysis and alkylating agents leads to abasic sites also and 8-oxygonin lesions also. So these are the 8-oxygonin lesions. So the best and the only DNA repair pathway to correct abasic sites along with single strand breaks and the lesions caused due to 8-oxygonin is the base excision repair. Okay, so the single base excision repair can be carried out to correct abasic sites, single strand breaks and 8-oxygonin lesions. It has the high fidelity rate DNA repair process. Then there are replication errors also. Because of those replication errors, we find bases mismatch, a certain base is inserted, certain base is accidentally deleted. So these are the replication errors. And when a single base mismatch or insertion or deletion is happening, mismatch repair is the best DNA repair pathway which will come into its role and will have a high fidelity rate in DNA repair process due to a single base mismatch or insertion or deletion. Okay, so these are the DNA damaging agents, DNA lesions which are formed and the possible DNA repair pathways with its particular fidelity rate of DNA repair. So this was an overview about the DNA damaging agents, possible DNA damages caused and the mechanism of DNA repairs which have a particular application in that certain type of DNA damage. So thank you very much. This was the literature used for this compilation. In the next session, we will discuss about different DNA repair processes or mechanisms in detail. So thank you very much. Thanks for watching this video. If you are not subscribed yet, kindly subscribe to the channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos in this lecture series. Thank you very much. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating yourself.